Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. Lubricating oil for pumps and compressors. The video will deliver you knowledge about lubricating oil and why it is required for pumps and compressors, what is the properties of a lubricating oil and selection criteria, and how wear particle analysis is carried out on lubricating oils to prevent the machines from damage. Video become very interesting, hence please see the complete video. If you like this video, please share with your friends and colleagues. Lubricants, the substance which is interposed between two surfaces under relative motion with the objective of reducing friction and wear is called lubricant. There are four types of lubricants such as gaseous, example air, helium, nitrogen, hydrogen, liquid, mineral or synthetic oils, semi-solid, grease, solid, graphite, molybdenum, disulfide. Function of lubricants. Let us know, to reduce friction and wear between the contact surfaces, to carry away the heat, acts as a seal for contaminants, keep the acting surfaces clean, perform at low as well as elevated temperatures, carry heavy loads. Why lube oil is required in pumps and compressors? Pumps and compressors are subjected to relative motion in bearings, piston, cylinder, screws and produce heat due to friction. To reduce friction due to surface contact and to take away the heat dissipated during friction, lubricating oils are used in compressors. Screw compressors use lube oil for sealing also in roots. Therefore, lube oil system is required in all compressors. There are two types of lubrications, splash lubrication and forced lubrication. So let us know splash lubrication. You can see a picture of a splash lubrication system. Splash lubrication is a lubrication system where scoops on the big ends of the connecting rods dip into the oil sump and splash the lubricants upward towards the cylinder, creating an oil mist which settle into droplets. The oil droplets then pass through drilling to the bearings and thereby lubricate the moving parts. You can see here in a picture, the crankcase, when a rotating counterweight is dipped into the oil and when it rotates, it splashes the oil which lubricate the bearings. Force feed lubrication. Oil is forced by oil pump from the crankcase to the main bearing and the camshaft bearings. Here you can see a picture where a gear pump is shown. Here you can see a gear pump is shown here. This is a gear pump and oil is pressurized oil is sent to the bearings for lubrication. Oil passages are drilled in the crankshaft to lead oil to the connecting rod bearings. The passage deliver oil from the main bearing journals to the rod bearing journals. Schematic lube oil system. Here you can see a schematic lube oil system where a pump which is shown is delivering oil. The oil is passes through a cooler. Here this is a cooler. Here oil is cooled and then it is delivered to the bearings through a filter. The oil filters are provided and these oil filters are of generally 10 micron. Hydrodynamic lubrication of pump sleeve bearings. A picture of rotor in general bearing is shown under lubrication stage. The first condition showing when rotor is under rest in bearing and metal to metal contact of surfaces. The second picture showing a startup of rotor and lubrication is in the starting phase. The third picture is showing when a hydrodynamic film of lubricant is produced and lubrication is started in the bearing. So there is no metal to metal contact and a hydrodynamic film is produced. We can see in the picture, this is a first state, first stage, load is here and this is rotor and it is coincide with the metal surface in the bearing. So there is a metal to metal contact. In the second stage, you can see in this picture, this is a startup. Due to lube oil pressure, rotor is just lifted and a film is getting produced, hydrodynamic film. In the third stage, you can see in this picture, a hydrodynamic film is produced and this is a pressure distribution of oil. So the complete lubrication is provided in the sleeve bearings. The rotating shaft drag a wedge of oil beneath it that develop a pressure great enough to support the shaft and eliminate contact friction between the shaft and bearing. Viscosity of lubricant is an important feature. The higher the viscosity, the higher the friction between oil and shaft, but the thicker the hydrodynamic film. Therefore, a suitable and a correct grade of oil is selected as per the lubrication required to dissipate the heat as well as to reduce the friction in the bearing. Tilted bed thrust bearings. A picture of tilted bed thrust bearing is shown. Now you can see these are the thrust pads here. These are the thrust pads and this is a oil inlet and this is a oil outlet. So this is a direction of main thrust. So this is a rotor and this is moving in the axial direction like this. So these pads are provided to take axial thrust in either direction. So they are flooded with lubricant to provide lubrication to reduce friction as well as to dissipate the heat generated during the friction. Tilting pad thrust bearings are designed to transfer high axial loads from rotating shaft with minimum power loss while simplifying installations and maintenance. Tilted bed thrust bearings are used for this purpose in large size pumps and compressors. So these each pad is free to tilt. These pads are free to tilt, resulting in a self-forming hydrodynamic film. The self-equalizing design balances the load between the pads and accommodate misalignment or deflection between the bearings. And collar. Flooded versus directed lubrications are provided. Either generally these bearings are provided with flooded lubrication, but wherever required, directed lubrication is also provided. In a flooded lubrication, more friction is produced. Therefore, if speeds are higher of a shaft, then directed lubrications are provided. How to select good lube oil? So the properties of lube oil is shown here in the slide. The first property is viscosity. Viscosity is a measure of a fluid resistance to flow. It describes the internal friction of a moving fluid. A fluid with large viscosity resists motion because its molecular makeup gives a lot of internal friction. Second is a flash point. The flash point of an oil is the temperature at which the liquid gives off sufficient vapors to ignite upon exposure of an open flame. A liquid is considered to be flammable if its flash point is less than 60 degrees centigrade. The third point is a fire point. Fire point, what is fire point? The fire point is a temperature at which lubricant combustion will be started and sustained. Pour point. What is pour point? Pour point is a temperature where lubricant cease to flow. So this is also a very important property. The lubricant should not cease to flow. Otherwise, our purpose of lubrication will be completely nullified. Rust and corrosion protection. The oil must have a property. It should not give a rust to the components of the machine. So there should not be a rusting, and this should protect the corrosion. If any corrosion occurs, that should be protected by the lubricant. High oxidation stability. The lube oil should not be oxidized. If it will oxidized, its properties will be lost and our purpose will be not solved. Therefore, the lube oil should have a high oxidation stability. Non-foaming. The foaming should not occur in a lubrication. If foaming will occur, then this will not provide sufficient lubrication to the machine. Demulsibility. Demulsibility is a measure in oil ability to release water. So water that enters a hydraulic system can emulsify mixing of oil and water and promote the collection of dust, grit and dirt, which can adversely affect the operation of machines. So therefore, lubricant must have a demulsibility property. Filtrability without depletion of additives. The additives are mixed in the lubricant to improve the various properties of a lubricant. Therefore, these additives should not be filtered in an oil filter. Therefore, the lubricant must have a good property of this. They should not be, their additives should not be depleted while oil is filtered through a filter. Wear particle analysis, ferrography. This is an important technique of wear particle analysis for critical machines. All industries use very critical machines which are always required to run the plant. They cannot survive for any breakdown for those critical machines. So therefore, as a preventive measure, ferrography is carried out to know the condition of oil. That is called condition monitoring of lubricating oil. So ferrography is a special type of oil analysis used to study particle wear in machines components through analysis of contaminants in lubricating oil. It is related to tribology, study of friction between interacting surfaces. It can be used to predict the diagnose errors occurring on machinery. Ferrographic analysis determines the number, size and shape of wear particles. By monitoring particles generated by wear or environmental contamination, critical stage of accelerated wear can be detected, which precedes costly and dangerous component failures. Therefore, the ferrography is carried out of critical machine lubricating oils, and according to condition monitoring, if required, oil is replaced with a fresh lubricating oil. Recommended oils and selection. Use only manufacturer recommended lube oil for your pump and compressors. Change the lube oil as recommended by manufacturer after machine operating hours. Various grade of compressor oils are manufactured by IOCL, BPCL, HP for air gas compressor and pumps. Specifications are readily available at their websites. The oil numbers in IOCL, BPCL, HP show their average kinematic viscosity at 40 degrees centigrade. For example, if oil number is a servopress T68, then viscosity in CST shall be within 62 to 74. Mineral and synthetic oils are used for this purpose, lubrication of the bearings. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below and share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.